I'm an incident meteorologist, so I make weather forecasts for the fire. I help keep the firefighters informed of, how the winds and the weather are going to be changing, so they don't get surprised and caught off guard. Help keep them safe. Behind us is a remote automated weather station, also called a ROS. We use these to get current weather conditions on a fire. This right here is actually a radiometer. It measures the amount of radiation we're getting from the sun. This is for measuring the wind direction, and this is the wind speed. We call that an anemometer. Here in the honeycomb, we call it, we have the temperature and the humidity. And this honeycomb is specially designed. You'll see it's white, so it doesn't absorb sunlight very well. It doesn't heat up very much, and it keeps the sun directly off the thermometer and the hygrometer, which hygrometer measures the humidity. And it also lets the air flow through, especially when the wind blows, and that's the way to get a very accurate temperature reading without, the sun directly beating on it. And then over here, down here, we have what's called a 10-hour fuel stick, and basically that just it's wired into the whole system. As the humidity goes up and down, it changes the amount of moisture that's in that piece of wood, and the sensor is able to detect that and report back what the fuel moisture is, which has a lot to do with how hot it'll burn. And then the final piece over here is just a bucket for capturing the rain. And there's a little, basically it's kind of a spoon on the inside on a lever. And as the water drains into the can, it causes it to tip back and forth. And each one of those clicks, it records a hundredth of an inch of rainfall. And that's, we just count the clicks basically to measure the rainfall. It gets transmitted once an hour, and it'll show up back in our incident command post. So we can also use that to monitor the weather on the fire, as well as observations taken on the line by firefighters.